The vice chairperson of the House Committee on Legislative Franchises admits lawmakers are growing frustrated over the repeated absence of Pastor Kibuloy in their hearings. Surigao del Sur Representative Johnny Pimentel says Kibuloy's attendance can clarify issues surrounding the ownership of Suarasug Media Corporation. Aside from Kibuloy's absence, Pimentel also slammed SMNI for repeatedly defying the suspension order of the National Telecommunications Commission.
They think they're above the law. They act with impunity. They do not care whether this regulatory body is telling us, already told them not to operate. It is very important that Pastor Kibuloy attends the hearing because he is the main actor of this inquiry. He owns 1.5% of the stocks of Suarasug. But then the Kingdom of Jesus Christ owns 95%. And we all know who is the head of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, and which is Pastor Apollo Kibuloy. Although he does not involve himself to the day-to-day operations, but he could be the one who could answer with regards to the issue of the ownership.
Embattled televangelist Apollo Kibuloy subpoenaed by a congressional panel for snubbing hearings into the franchise of his media arm TV network SMNI. Vivian Gulia reports.
The House Committee on Legislative Franchises has started hearing the bill seeking to revoke the franchise of Sunshine Media Network International over alleged franchise violations. Pastor Apollo Kibuloy, who is said to be an honorary chairman of the broadcast network, was still a no-show in Wednesday's panel hearing. He also did not appear during the committee hearings on the House resolution urging the National Telecommunications Commission to suspend SMNI's operations. That is why the panel approved a motion to issue a subpoena for Kibuloy to attend the next hearing.
If Pastor Kibuloy does not appear, then we will be constrained to move for a contempt order, and after he will not, hindi pa rin siya sisipot, eh, yun na yung warrant.
Pastor Apollo Kibuloy is the honorary chairman of SMNI. And he's not part of the day-to-day operation of SMNI.
While SMNI's broadcast operations remain suspended by the NTC pending the resolution of its administrative case, Kabataan Partylist Representative Raul Manuel accused the network of continuing to air on its online platforms statements that are false and red-tag certain personalities. In a video clip presented by Manuel before the panel, SMNI anchor Jeffrey K. Eric Celis linked a cousin of the president to the communist group. Manuel also showed an online post of SMNI News where attorney Harry Roque linked a UN rapporteur to a terrorist group.
Hindi ko lang matanggap, Mr. Chair, na parang na parang wala na pong pinipili ang SMNI. Parang kahit sino na lang na tingin nila ay hindi aligned sa kanilang views ay kalaban na ng bayan at dapat nang i-red tag.
Mga anchors po namin, nasa kanila po ang karapatan na magsalita kung anong gusto nilang sabihin. Kung yan po ang nakikita po nila, then yun po yung komento po nila, opinion po nila. Kung ano po yung komento ng mga anchors po namin, hindi po yung stand ng company.
Lawmakers urged regulatory agencies to act on alleged continued red tagging on SMNI's online platforms.
Ang NTC po, Mr. Chair, alam ko nag-cancel po kayo or nag-suspend po kayo ng website. Tama? Na mga alternative media, halimbawa nitong SMNI, na the same pa rin naman po yung content.
We had a preliminary discussion with the MTRCB, and we were advised that yung suspension order po nila includes not only the free-to-air but on other platforms. Should the MTRCB decide to endorse that suspension order to the NTC for suspension on other platforms, perhaps we can consider, the NTC can consider that.
If the MTRCB decided to suspend or cancel a program in all kinds of media platforms, and said decision is final and executory, we can endorse it to the NTC in order for them to assist us in implementation of said decision.
SM&I, for its part, asserted freedom of expression and freedom of the press, adding that they are open to receiving complaints and disciplining their employees if investigation shows it is warranted. The committee will schedule another hearing to continue deliberating on SM&I's alleged franchise violations. Meanwhile, Kibuloy has a standing Senate subpoena for failing to show up during Senate hearings on the alleged abuses committed by the Davao-based pastor and his church, the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
There's no end in sight to the bicameral bickering over charter change. Philippine senators once again took a swipe at the lower chamber after House Majority Leader Manuel Jose Dalipe challenged them to bear their positions in charter change. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel asserts reviewing the charter should not be rushed. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva, meanwhile, posed a question in response to Dalipe, asking who he was to make such a dare. Villanueva's comment did not sit well with House lawmakers.
With respect doon sa opinion ni... Sino nga ulit yun?
Sir,
sino ba yung
quote?
Ano, sino nagsabi?
The Majority Leader of the Senate,
sir,
Senator.
Sino yun?
Thank you, sir.
I mean, look, it was the majority leader of Congress who they know each other. So let's not, this is why kami sa Congress, gusto namin i-elevate yung discussion. Pag-usapan natin yung merits nung amendments. So I would like to remind the good majority leader of the Senate na wala naman tayong name calling at pagmamaliit.
Well, again, this is where parliamentary courtesy should come in, no? You know, we respect, there must be some respect in the opinion of the member. So, wag nating umpisahan ng ganyan kasi hindi magandang pangitain yun, ika nga. If the majority leader has posed a challenge to them, it is because he is just thinking that the proposal is an urgent proposal.
Another House lawmaker says he does not understand the fierce opposition against amending the economic provisions of the charter.
I don't know why so many people are afraid of this amendments to our constitution. You know, we are the only country who does not amend our constitution regularly to fit with the times. We must be globally competitive. Yeah. And now is the time to open up the economy of our country.